Well, coaches and trainers play a large role in an athlete's life, but there are others who have a great impact as well. Rich Carey explains in this week's Carey's Corner.
Back in the early 1960s, I began coaching baseball with the late, great George Player at Weymouth High School. At one of our first practices, I was about to correct what I considered a flaw in a boy's batting stance. I asked him, "Who taught you to hold a bat like that?" "My father," he answered. With that, I backed off and let him do his own thing. The boy made the team and had a pretty good season. Whether he would have had a better one if he had held his arms differently, I don't know. But I'm glad I did not try to change him. For parents are usually not only our first, but also our best teachers and coaches, from whom we learn much during our first 5 years in the school of our home in our backyard playing field. In that sense, most of us were homeschooled. And if we are fortunate, those values we learned in and around our homes will be reinforced later in the more formal teaching and coaching settings in which we find ourselves. All of which should remind us to be grateful for our mothers and fathers, not on just 2 days a year, and not for just teaching us how to hold a tennis racket, hockey stick, or a baseball bat, but on every day for having given us life. After all, without them, we wouldn't be here. Until next week, this is Rich Carey reminding you that at Carey's Corner, you always have someone in your corner.